They're 15th on the log.
15. We never say die.
Yeah.
So you wait.
Yeah, you'll survive. Like,
yes.
You definitely will survive.
That's an area I would rather not make it.
You'd rather keep quiet. Yes. Nothing at all. All right. Okay, let's go to the Daily Guide newspaper. I think we've looked at most of the stories here. But maybe I'll stay on the back page. The Upper East story. About 82% of residents in the Upper East region defecate in the open. The remaining 80% of the people either use water closets or public toilets, making the foremost of the regions whose population defecates openly. The Upper West region followed next with 79%, and the Northern region with 73%. Not very interesting statistics. Yvonne, I'll start with you on this one.
My question is, so what are we doing about it? Upper East is in Ghana, and we have this data, this information. What are we doing about it? And probably whose responsibility? I think that it's time you quickly pick up our responsibilities and put our acts together and get it done, because it's not a good information. I quite remember right in kindergarten they said cleanliness is next to godliness.
Yes.
At least if you don't know anything, we should know that cleanliness is next to godliness.
But it looks like we've all forgotten.
That's surprising. So, I mean, I think that it's time we look at these things. Because just last year or last 2 years, we had cholera outbreak.
Yes. Yeah.
And so we should be asking ourselves. Same way, there was a flood. I mean,
June.
Yes. Floods, yeah. So what is our problem? What are we doing as a nation? What are we doing?
That's a
question.
This is an area you want.
Yes, I think
climate change.
Climate change. Ah, right.
I think that it says something about how we have handled sanitation and environmental sanitation. You know, I mean the point you make about cleanliness next to godliness is true. But with regard to this, I think the whole problem started when we privatized that sector. Sanitation is a public issue. And it has to be handled as such. It's a state responsibility. It doesn't mean that you don't engage private institutions or other interested groups to go into that sector. But the lead responsibility is for the state to take responsibility and put in resources to make sure.
Well, now they've started the sanitation day.
You said?
They've started some sanitation day.
Well, but it's all over the country. In fact, yesterday there was a program, and I think it was in your station or another one, about the problems we are having with even managing the waste that we create. This is part of it. Unfortunately, the Millennium Development Goals, there's something in it about sanitation, and we have claimed that we have moved ahead with it. In many of the reports that have been written on this particular goal, we are claiming so much, but this statistics is saying something different. Of course, statistics hide a lot of information, but given the situation we find ourselves in this country, we should be worried. September, we are going to New York. We are going to speak about the Sustainable Development Goals, which we are moving into after the Millennium Development Goals. And we are going to tout all the good things that we have done with regard to sanitation. It is not right. It is not right. And we must take some of these things seriously. And I still insist that it's a public policy issue. Sanitation, the lead role must be the state. And then you can engage other agencies to be part of it.
I wouldn't allow Gifty to talk about sanitation, because I know she's going to hit hard at certain agencies. I'd rather pick your thoughts on the FDA's directive yesterday. We heard the news about the FDA banning bleaching products from 2016. You mentioned earlier in one of your submissions our porous borders.
Right.
And yesterday I was wondering, how will the FDA do it? I mean, do you think this will be effective? Because we have so many, things that have been banned in this country, but you see them everywhere. A typical example is firecrackers.
Right.
Banned, but every Christmas we see it here.
Right. Okay, so. Right. Which creams are they going to ban? The ones that do bleach, or the ones that lighting, or the ones that do? you know, because I have
you directly.
Madam, please.
The one with the hydroquinones.
Okay. Mm-hmm. That one, what does it do? Does it bleach? Does it tone or does it like?
That's all. So it depends on the quantity, the content of that in the cream or whatever.
Okay.
So based on the standards set up for Ghana now and the statistics showing that we are having problems with our skin, mm-hmm. causing skin cancer, damages to the skin and all that,
right.
It is in the right mandate of the FDA to say that. Then we are not going to allow such creams and lotions with such...
But how are you going to ensure it? Because we know, for instance, you don't allow fake drugs to come into our country.
Yes.
But every now and then we see fake drugs.
They are not supposed to allow. Not that they don't allow. They're not supposed to.
She is on a roll this morning.
I know.
Yeah. How do you ensure it?
First and foremost, we make sure that the products that are coming in, registration and all that, are in the right standard. Without this hydroquinone. And then also make what we call the post-marketing surveillance.
Okay.
Yes, we do registration. We do see some of these things, even though we don't allow.
Right.
And that's the essence of post-marketing surveillance.
Right.
No matter what, it's the whole world. It's a global issue.
So
therefore, we also find means. We find people like you to inform us.
Mm.
We see this on the market. Could you do something about
it? But have you seen all these billboards? Lightning cream.
Yes.
So by the 2016, by the set date, all these billboards.
Why 2016?
Because already
this country was saved by Dr. Kwame Nkrumah, who said action now. Why can't we just get up and say now? Because by between now and 2016, thank you, and people would have done whatever they have to do. And it will be an election year. The politicians
It is a time to give
because
some time to get
bleaching
them
is no respect of persons. From the religious leaders to politicians to they are bleaching. In fact, most of them
are you bleaching?
I know.
No.
Most of them
are bleaching.
Forgive me, but most of them are bleaching. I mean, it cuts across.
Yes.
So I mean, like everything that we politicize in this country, why can't we get up and say that enough is enough?
Yes, Gifty.
This young lady, Nana.
My colleague?
I'm a K. Ababrese, Nanaba, and, you know, others have, they started this campaign. They amounted, I saw some of the billboards. Mm-hmm. I'm sure they didn't get sponsors to sustain them.
Yes.
So it's been going on. We know it. Why can't we say that even by the end of this year? Why are we waiting till 2016?
So are you going to dismantle the billboards and things?
Well, they'll bring them down because you are not selling them anymore. Okay. Because already we have given approval to market such products. And then looking at the validation of the time, then you need to give some gap. If you want to really clear all this from the market, it's not a one-day action.
Yeah.
So now it's awareness. All the businessmen and women who deals in this will know that by this year, I cannot do it. Then, therefore, the FDA can say, because we had set up this date, we are not registering this anymore. Because now we have the limit for hydroquinone is about 2%. 2%. Okay. And that's okay. But we realize that it still can cause the problem we want to avoid.
Mm. But Nanaba asked the question, so how are you going to ensure that it will not come into this country anymore and the people are not hoarding and not people are not buying from, you know, from the black market?
We are represented in all the regions and the bodies.
Mm.
We also have assistance.
Other bodies?
Yes.
Nice.
You've been there for a long time.
I think the banning must be backed with other actions.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
For instance, the ways in which we portray women who have bleached their skins, especially if you look at the adverts that we have. Many of the women they are using to sell products have either bleached their skin or they are really very fair.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And I think the image of fair is beautiful.
Yeah.
It's a problem because it's not always the case.
It's not always.
Yes, actually, we are Africans and we are all dark and we should be dark because that's our beauty.
Yeah.
And this should be reflected in our messages.
I'm also an African.
Yeah.
Yes. No, but you are
we're different shades. You're natural, yes. All that. Some are fair, and it's unnatural. When Amake Abebrese started this thing about black is beautiful, we also had a social group that coming up to say what? Fair ladies rock.
Yeah. Lighting rock.
The kind of thing that is going. Not a competition.
Yes.
Everybody, I mean, keep your color, whatever color you have, just keep it neat and clean. No need for you to bleach. In any case, most of them, they smell.
Yeah.
After using the cream, they smell. And I wonder if they can't smell it. It's so bad, some are bleaching their own babies.
Wow.
Oh, yes, for it to seem as if they are naturally fair, but they are not.
Wow.
So do you also work with the advertising companies? Because they are also to blame. If you are selling a product, just sell the product. Don't put it beside a woman's body.
Not just a woman, a fair woman.
That worries me. You know, sometimes I see some billboards and I'm wondering, did you really have to put the product next to a woman?
Wondering.
Like a photocopier machine. Like a lady.
Sitting by it. Yes, we deal with that. Yes, the N1. I don't know.
Don't sell the body of a woman.
Gihok Distilleries. Gihok, a national state institution. And then the drink, I don't know what they call it. It was at the back pocket of a woman. Oh. And you could see her butt and all that. Gihok Distilleries. State.
Okay. That will be it for now. We're joining Samaki Tete in the kitchen. Mm-hmm. We are cooking a ampesi and a boom. You like it?
I love it.
You do?
I do.
We'll invite my special you food. For some tasting.
Okay. Eating or tasting?
Just taste. It's so small.
Okay. Have a good morning. I'll see you later.
And also, Dr. Rose Mensakutin, Director for Abantu for Development. Dr. Mensakutin, it was such a lovely time having you here. Pleasure to have you here. Yeah, and also, Mrs. Here. Yvonne Edubwahin, a pharmacist and a senior regulator with FDA. You have a big post. Senior regulator.
Yes.
And she's working. She's making an impact.
You know?
Yes.
Thank you so much for spending time.
I just want to say just one thing.
Please.
I'm pleading that government, just as they've set money aside for the creative industry and other institutions to support them, civil society is doing so much work that government, including the President Mount International Platform, and takes credit for. They should set some money aside in the next budget to support civil society organizations like Abantu, like the ARC Foundation, like WorldJack and others, NetRight and others, for them to support, continue doing what they are doing. ARC Foundation nearly folded up. It's the only well-instituted shelter that we have in this country for battered women and children. Abantu has trained a lot of women who have gone into the assemblies and into parliament as well. I don't know if they will be able to afford it or can do it this time. It's about time they turn their eyes to civil society and support them, because we are middle-income and country. We have attained the middle income status now. So the donors are going.
Middle income.
We are not getting the grants anymore. So government, you are doing a great job. We appreciate
no sarcasm. Women.
No sarcasm.
Yeah.
We know, Mr. President, especially, you appreciate women. And we thank you. But please, turn your eye this time, support civil society with some money.
Okay.
Even if it's half of what you are giving to the creative industry and everything. Please, we like it. Thank
Let
you.
Me cut you here. And I'll still just 1 minute of Samoki's time. You reported from the presidency.
Yes.
So you knew exactly what these victims of the accident have been talking about.
Yeah.
I'll give you just 1 minute to comment on it.
I'm disappointed in our president, I must say.
Why?
Because of the way he spoke to Manasseh Azure Awuni yesterday. Yes, maybe he
the president of the GJA.
Of the GJA. Yeah, the president, not Mr. President. Oh, sorry. He went to visit the victims, the accident victims and all that was nice. But you see, Nanaba, we have something we call sensitivity. Even if the chief of staff told you that everything the journalist told you was a lie, you could have said that, listen, we are still investigating. I've heard the side of the chief of staff. My journalists have also told me this. We are going to analyze and see that at the right time will come out. These boys and girls are still at 37. Mm-hmm. And you come out and specifically even mention names. Napoleon Atukito, that he was sleeping, and who you were told by somebody who has even turned out not to have been even in the bus. And you discount the report of your own journalist. Yes. It is in bad taste. And I will plead, he's my boss, Boss Ram, and I respect him and all that. But I think he must come out and apologize. If for nothing at all, for the fact that we lost a life.
Yes.
And those boys, I don't know if you've been to the hospital, one of your staff is there, up in there. They are in such a sad situation. I wouldn't say they are not critical, so don't worry. But in a sad situation, they don't need to hear their president say this. This is the time they need their president to stand by them, to say that something needs to be done. Our journalists need to be treated well. And it's true, for a long time, journalists have not been treated right. I have been a beneficiary of what a GJA president can do when she decides to, Mrs. Gifty Afeni Dadzi, and I salute her. And many people have mentioned her name. I would have been toast, but she stood up and said, listen, I believe my report. I didn't watch it, but let's all sit down and watch the program and see if indeed she said that. And when they did, they realized, I didn't say that I was saved. Let's take our time. Investigate the matter. What happened? Accident, whatever, even if it was caused by the journalist, it's unfortunate. And we need to be sensitive about that.
All right.
So, Boss Ram, I think you need to come again.
Thank you very much, Gifty Auntie.